Hello there and welcome. I'm Ole Brøgger, and if you're new here, I really hope I'll earn your subscription today. Now, what is this? This is the new Hansmaker D1 Ultra. It's a 30W fiber laser and a 20W diode laser. And Hansmaker was so kind to send me this sample before they're running their Kickstarter campaign, and we're going to have a look at it. Hansmaker did send me this for free, but they didn't pay me or there's no money between us, so everything I have to say is my own opinion and my own words. So we better get started. So who is Hansmaker? Well, I didn't know until 3 months ago when they reached out to me and asked me if I wanted to test out one of their new products. And the company is relatively new, but they are not unfamiliar with making lasers. The parent company, Hanslaser, makes huge industrial lasers. They have been developing lasers for over 30 years now. Hansmaker is an offspring of Hanslaser, and their purpose is to make lasers for hobbyists and small business owners. This is their new product, the Hansmaker D1 Ultra. Earlier this year, they launched their first product, the F1 Pro, and it is a 20W fiber laser. This is a 30W fiber laser with a 20W diode laser, so it will give you a lot of versatility. Now we're talking about diode and fiber. What are all those kinds? Well, there is three common laser types. There is the diode laser, the CO2 laser, and the fiber laser. So what is the difference and what can they do? The diode laser is very cheap to make. And the first diode lasers were about 2 to 5 watts. They could only engrave in wood and some leather. Later, they came up with some 10W lasers, 20W, now 30 and 40W, and I have even seen 100 and 120W diode lasers. So they are getting very powerful. And then we have the CO2 lasers, and they can cut and engrave in all kinds of materials except for metal. And then we have the fiber laser. Fiber laser is made for cutting and engraving in metal. And this is what this machine can do. This laser comes with a lot of accessories. You could get a rotor extension and then you can get a conveyor. And that's pretty cool because then you can just put up all your material and you can mass produce it through the laser. Hansmaker sent me the basic kit and we are going to have a look what's inside that. We are going to test it and see what kind of materials we can put through. And I'm very excited about this metal thing because I've never been able to engrave and cut metal with machines I already got. I have tried some fiber lasers before, but this excites me a lot. But first, I'm going to walk you through what comes with this basic kit. Okay, this is all the stuff that was in the box. First, of course, we have the machine. We have a power supply, 300 watts, 24 volts, and 12.5 amps. There's a touch screen. We have some tools, a Phillips screwdriver, and a tiny Allen key. A cloth for the lens, keys. We have some brackets that can be mounted here in the bottom of the laser to hold whatever you're going to burn. And then you can be very consistent in placing your materials. USB cable, and what I notice here, and I have never seen that on a laser before, USB-C. Now, thumbs up for that, Hansmaker, because that's the way to go. A USB-C adapter. We also got some test materials here. We got some keychains. We have a coaster. It's made out of stone. I think it's called slate in English. Business cards, a piece of leather. There's also a piece of leather down here. And then we got some pendants. Two rounds and two heart shapes. There's also some cardboard. I think this is coated with some black and it has white. piece of acrylic, piece of 3mm plywood. That's actually very nice to have a lot of test material. We also got the exhaust fan here. It's a very powerful fan from the specs. And I have to say, this is a sample, so I don't think Hansmaker was aware of I'm living in EU, and this is not an EU plug. I think this is a US plug. But it's not a problem. I can put an adapter and then we are going. I just checked the duct booster fan here and it is compatible with 240 volts. So no problem there. There was also a 80mm hose and a 10mm hose that I already put out through my window because that was 3 meter long. And we are going to test that because it's gonna be smelly when we're burning some wood here. We also have safety goggles. And safety goggles, I will say it again, it is one of the most important things when working with a laser. Now, this laser has an enclosure with safety glass, but if you open it up and you have a piece of material that is larger than the cutting area and you just want to burn it apart, you need to have this machine open. It's not good not using these, because one shot of the laser in your eye, it's done. Stay safe when you're using a laser. And I will say it again, lasers are tools, not toys. And you can make some awesome things with a laser. And finally, we have a bottom plate. This plate has some, I don't know what you call it, some riffles down here so you can get an airflow. And this is a very good thing to have when you are going to cut through some stuff, because we need airflow underneath the material we are cutting. And final thing, I know that I have told you before in my previous videos, I never read instructions. This is just very simple and it is high quality paper, very clear images, good illustrations, what's in the box, and very few steps to get started. If we look inside here, we have the base plate for putting in all your stuff and materials. And then up here, we have the business end. And here is the lens cover. And this is a huge lens. Here on the side of the machine, we have all the input connectors and we have all the buttons that are on this machine. We have emergency stop, we have a power button, key lock, focus or manual focusing. This is for the revolving table, for the rotary tool. This is for the conveyor belt. We have for a foot pedal. This is for the air purifier. Then we have some input USB-A here, and this is the connection for your PC or Mac computer. And here on the back, I have the exhaust port, and I've made this hose ready just to connect it here. We have the power input, and then we have the connector for the touch display. I will connect everything now, and then we can make the first test. I have installed the M+ software for this laser cutter or engraver. And unfortunately, it doesn't support light burn yet, but I think in the future it will. But let's see what this software actually can do. It will need some calibration. The motor will need to do a reset every time you plug it in. I know this will be fixed in the future, so it will remember the last position. Let's start out with a simple engraving. I have put a piece of plywood on the bed and used the built-in camera so I can line up my text. First, I'll do a line engrave. This is very fast. This is real time. And then we can do a fill engrave. It takes a tiny bit longer, but still it's very fast. I think the speed of this machine is quite impressive. Let's try out one of the credit cards that came with this machine. I took a picture again with the built-in camera, aligned up my text, and just watch this. I set up this engraving so it will do a line engrave first, and then it will do a fill engrave. Did you see it? Line engrave took less than a second, 15 milliseconds to be exact. Let's watch it again. It slowed down to 1/8 of speed. Fill engrave takes a bit longer, still fast with 18 seconds. Now let's try to do some metal. I have this piece of 1 mm metal coins, and I just took one of the flowers that were already in the shape library. And this is just awesome. I sped up the footage a bit here because it took about 2.5 minutes to make an engraving like this. And then I tried out a pen. I want to engrave my own name, and with the help from the camera, it's pretty easy to line up my engraving. And this is real time. It just took a split second, and it looks beautiful. Now I need to put on my safety goggles, because I want to engrave more metal. I want to put my name on this old knife. And the knife was so long, I couldn't close the doors to the laser. Always use goggles if the laser is open. But just listen to this. The metal sings when it's engraved. Oh, just look at this. I love it. Let's try to put my own logo on this knife. And I think this looks great. Now let's try to do a wood cutting and engraving test. This is real time and I'm cutting this wood with full power. But look at those scorch marks. After 3 passes, it cuts right through like it was butter. But the result speaks for itself. There's too many scorch marks. So I turned down the power and made more passes. It takes approximately the same time. But look at this. There is almost no scorch marks. And if you are more patient, you can actually have no scorch marks at all. And when you get this dial in, it will just be perfect. It's all about speed, passes, and power. Now let's try a multi-cut test. This first cut is real time, and then I will speed it up and make 6 identical cuts and engraving on this piece of plywood. Now this was weird. 2 of the hearts were not all the way through, and I don't know if it's just the wood, but it's like it almost came through. And I can just pop it out and it's not a problem, but it's just weird that it didn't fall out. And look at this, there is still a bit of scorch marks, but I think it's okay, it's just on the backside. I think this result is pretty okay. And let's try to do the same heart in a piece of acrylic. It takes a bit longer to cut through, but I think this looks pretty good. And another piece of wood. This is the keychain. Let's give mom her own keychain. And this is actually real time. I think this is pretty fast. And now mom knows what car keys is for her car. Now this laser can do some very interesting stuff. It has a built-in 3D scanning. And I put some blue tape around a can. And now we can make a 3D scan of the object. It takes about 1 second per dot, so I speeded up the video. When the scanning is done, we get a 3D model of the area where we're going to engrave. I also did some framing through the preview function, so I could make sure that the text is heading right where I wanted it. And then I started the engraving. It engraves a bit different from the usual flat surfaces, and it takes a bit longer, but it just looks awesome. And there is no skew or twisting in the letters. Everything is just looking perfect. But I want to do some more metal work. So I made one of these pendants, and this is real-time engraving, and you can see how fast this is. You can make a bunch of these in very short time. And I could actually do this faster because I gave it too many passes and too much power, so the engraved heart in the middle was a bit overdone. I also had to pick it up with a tweezer because that was hot. And again, it's all about speed, power, and number of passes. Now this is the Hansmaker D1 Ultra. A 30W fiber laser and a 20W diode laser. And I think Hansmaker did an amazing job building this machine. It is very easy to use, and the M+ software, it is still in development and needs some tweaks here and there, but the functionality is there. It's just some minor annoyances that I found in the software, and then it is almost perfect. So, a great shout out to Hansmaker for letting me try out this machine. And the result, well, it speaks for itself. You can do metalwork, you can do woodwork, you can do acrylics, and make some very amazing engravings. Yep, and even cutting wood is possible with this machine, even without making scorching. And as I said earlier in this video, it is all about adjusting the speed, the power, and the number of passes over a material to get a perfect result. And I think, yeah, this actually speaks for itself. No scorch marks. And sometimes I need to sand something down because it has scorch marks if it has to look pretty. But this, you can just take it out of this cutter and engraver and ship it to anyone who needs something like this. I think it is worth having a look at this machine and sign up for the Kickstarter if this is for you. And one of the things that actually impresses me, and I was not aware this machine was capable of it has a built-in camera with a 3D AI scanning tool, and then you can actually engrave stuff that is not flat, even without a rotary table. So, a very huge thumbs up for making this software, Hansmaker. I'm quite impressed over this machine. And for my hobby, this machine will be an excellent addition to all the tools that I already have, and it will open up a lot of new possibilities. Actually, ideas is stockpiling in my head, and it's almost going to explode of ideas what I can do with this machine. And I have already tried one of my ideas and it worked perfectly. I just had to try this out amongst all the ideas I have for this machine. And I will show you after we have seen a close-up of some of the stuff that I have cut and engraved. So I made an inspiration coin, and this inspiration coin is for my players when I give them some inspiration. So instead of them writing down on a piece of paper, I got an inspiration point, I can give them this coin, and if they want to use it, they can give it back to me. And I think it's just so nice to have some hands-on artifacts in the game. It just makes it more, yeah, lively. Thank you so much for watching this to the end, and a big shout out to Hansmaker for sending me this machine. All links are in the description, and you can go check out Hansmaker. They have a YouTube channel, and most important, their Kickstarter. Go check out their Kickstarter because amazing stuff is going on over there. This is it for now, and if you already haven't done it, please hit that subscribe button and leave a comment below what you think of this incredible machine. And give me a thumbs up if you like this video, thumbs down if you don't. And I will see you soon with stuff made on this machine. Goodbye for now.